It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's Maddest Rider, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1602, recorded on Tuesday, December 20th, 2016. Snowballs and Shoelaces. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we got some amazing ways for kids to save some time. Stop tying your shoelaces. I have a gadget for you for my crappy corner that only cost $1 and the best luggage you've ever seen. All next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the Sandlum Show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease.
Under pathology.
Rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now! And here we are, ready for the Giz Wiz. Here he is, the master of gadgets. Dick DeBartolo, how are you doing?
I'm doing fine, sir. And you?
Doing great. Rushing into the show. I came here. I'm like still tidying up a little bit. It's been a rush. I'm late for the show. We're recording a day early, and that threw me all off. So.
We're here though. And also, you just did a 24-hour show too, right?
I did. Over the weekend, I did a 24-hour live stream, holiday themed. I did all sorts of different challenges and games during the 24-hour stream. It was just a ton of fun. 24 hours of content.
Do you run any videos? So like while the video's running, you can go to the bathroom?
Nope. If I have to go to the bathroom, they look at an empty chair, basically.
I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was a really, really fun time. There's just almost too many memories to come up with just one. I mean, there was one point where I tried to eat a gigantic chocolate Hershey's Kiss in under a minute, and I made myself sick. And so, like, for the next, like, 30 minutes, I was like, oh. Gosh, I think I gotta go to the bathroom. It was bad.
I tuned in and it looked like you had a cake on your head.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So I was supposed to. One of the things that I normally do is I pie myself for a tip, and so I had gotten instead of a pie a log of one of the chocolate logs.
Oh.
And normally you slice it up and give it to people, but the directions said that you keep it in the freezer. And I didn't thaw it ahead of time, so I pulled out this chocolate log. I'm imagining that I would, pie myself, or I would stick it on my face. It's rock solid. It was a solid, chunk of chocolate. So there was no way that I was going to be able to put that in my face without breaking my nose. So instead, I went ahead and wore it as a hat and used some tinsel to keep it affixed. And it stayed affixed pretty well, and it went really well. It was 24 hours of just shenanigans and crazy
quality
stuff.
Quality material.
Exactly.
I can see.
Exactly. So, and then after that, my the people on Twitch who subscribe to me, they call themselves a chat fam. They did another 24-hour stream where each member of the fam took a different segment of time, and that went for another 24 hours, and they ended up raising $1,300 for charity. So that was just absolutely amazing, and that just really warmed my heart. So if you were part of the chat fam, you got 48 hours of nonstop content this last weekend. It was an awful lot of fun this past weekend. So, yeah, we had a great time. It's been crazy.
Excellent.
Been crazy. And then I slept for like 12 hours. Yeah, exactly. Now here's more content. Here you go.
One more hour of content.
Exactly.
Okay, should we just jump in?
Let's jump in.
Okay, we're going to start with, actually, both these things could be for kids. The second one is for adults and kids, actually the third one. But we're going to start out with a fun thing for kids. And here it is.
Here we go.
Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer in the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're talking about the Big Red Rooster. And the Big Red Rooster is actually, it looks like everything but a rooster. We have a dog, We have a dino. We have a cat over there. But let me tell you about what the big red rooster are. These are kids' alarm clocks with built-in projectors, okay? So basically, this is the little doggy guy. He comes with an AC adapter. Or if you want it to be totally portable, he can run on 3C batteries. All right, so he's easy to set the time. So you push that, and then you hold the time set in, and then this is the up and down arrow. But this is the projector part. So now you do that, and there's the time up on the ceiling. I'm going to go shut the lights off so you can see. All right, so now the kid can have this on all night. Also, the doggy's head turns. So you can face the time anywhere toward where the child's sleeping in bed.
Or seems really bright.
It is, yeah.
You can always see that. And then there's also on the other side, let me just find a little button here, is a picture. So you can have a doggy with the time or the doggy by himself. And there are four different pictures of dogs in here. Now, unfortunately, you cannot change the images. Just the four that are in there are in there. Okay, this is the best one, I think.
Look at this stock photo of a dog.
Doing here.
Different stock photo of a dog.
Actually, I think it's the people who make the clock, their dogs.
Oh, that's interesting.
Now, at the back of the clock is a little timer. Very easy to use. It says 10, 30, and on. So you can have the projection on all night. Or you can have the time go off after 10 minutes, or I'm going to even double check again. Yeah, it's 10 and 30. 10, 30, or off, or 10, 30, and on all night. So that's pretty neat. And I think those are all the features of it. That's the dino. They're very cute, and they are $29 on Amazon. I think the list is $39. But $29.99, Amazon Prime. And this is kind of strange. The company's very first clock was the rocket ship. And look at this. The rocket ship only got 3 stars from 25 people. Then they started adding the animals. And the
cat
got 5 stars from 24 people. And the dog got 5 stars from 31 people. So maybe they thought the dog and cat are cuter, but I think the dino's cute too. Anyway, that's it. Big Red Rooster Projection Alarm Clocks. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I have my resume projected up there, but we don't have time for that. Bye.
But for only 10 minutes at a time. You can't keep it up there all night long.
Yeah.
It might embarrass the company. That's interesting, and I like it. I thought that the timer on the back. You know what? This could be used for that way. Have you? Every once in a while, my parents would put me in timeout, and they would say, in order for me to learn the clock, when this gets to 40, you're able to get out, of timeout. So I thought it was like, oh, that's great. Put a little timer on the back, so the kids know exactly how long 10 minutes is for timeout.
And they did this past Thanksgiving?
Exactly. Right. Exactly.
Oh, wow. You are a slow learner.
Exactly. And I remember one time they said, okay, you only have to take a 10-minute nap. And then they set my alarm for me. And then it was an hour later that the alarm went off. And I was like, gosh, dang it. You guys tricked me. So, yeah. It was... I like the little projection clock, and I think kids will too. I think that there's a big downside that you can't change the photo to your own photo.
I know. I guess the thing is you would have to have almost like a slide image.
Right. Nobody has those anymore.
No, exactly. Maybe they would have a way where you could send in your favorite pictures and $5 and they could make them, but... right now, I guess it's cost effective just to have the 4 pictures that they have.
Exactly. Yeah. I could imagine a little Pico projector, but not for $29.
Not for $29.99.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, I like it. I think it's cute. And, you know, if your child needs a clock, they like cats, they like dogs. I know when I was that age, if I just had a cat on my ceiling, I would have been happy, no matter if it was mine or not.
Yeah, me too,
So it's nice. Once again, it's available on Amazon.
And it's Amazon Prime, so probably if you're watching this live, or you might still be able to get it for Christmas.
Just in time for Christmas.
Just in time.
There you go.
Oh, is it Amazon? It is Prime.
Yeah,
oh, get it on Thursday.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, perfect.
Perfect. Okay, that's one gadget down.
Okay, now gadget two. Years ago when I was doing the show with Leo, it's almost 10 years ago, I went to the hardware show, and they were showing a product there called cruising coolers. These were ice chests with motors in them that you drove. You sat on
I
them.
I think I've seen these, like a little go-kart.
Yes, except it's all your beer and they have big tires. You can drive it on the beach.
Right.
Well, Leo and I laughed about it. And I don't know if their website, well, it's 10 years later. Not only are they making them, they have fast ones now. It used to be that when you went to the buy page, it had this disclaimer that these could be dangerous. You could be killed. They wanted to make sure that there was no liability.
Right, exactly. These are not motor safe. They don't have blinkers. They don't have headlights.
Yes. They're not road safe.
Right. If you put it on the road, you're going to have to pay a local tax. Like, yes, yeah, exactly. Yes.
All right. So this is now, I'm leading up to something I'm going to see at CES 2017. But let's take a look at the luggage you drive.
Oh, I'm excited. Oh man, the Mondo bag. My gosh, I can't tell if you'd look like a complete idiot.
Yes!
Or.
Hi, my name is Kevin O'Donnell, and I'm the inventor of Moto Bag. It all started a few years back after I met this little family of breakdancers. I sponsored them to fly out to New York to try out for Paul Abdul's With the Dance. As we're going through the airport, we're loaded up with backpacks and all the different gear, and the boys are taking turns as I'm pulling my carry-on, riding on top of it. All of a sudden, I got the idea, you know what? Why not motorize these? What a better way to get around. Well, I was going to need some help. And the first person I thought of was my buddy Boyd.
We just got back from Daytona 200. We won. And Kevin came with this idea about the moto bag. And I looked at it, and I thought, wow, this is a great idea. How can we make this a reality? You know, we've had all these different vehicles that we've put motors to. And I said we could motorize this. So immediately, we went out and started getting some parts. One of the biggest hurdles was fitting all of this into a carry-on size bag. We wanted to retain at least 85% of the interior, and all of the parts that we use had to be really small. We started with skateboard parts, rollerblade parts, scooter parts, and we thought it's a good start, but we had to make it work properly. We've got CNC machine, steering column, telescoping aluminum bars, foot pegs that pop out. We've got a lot of stuff that isn't on anything that's currently on the market.
It's carry-on size, it's got a 5 mile range, up to 8 miles an hour. It's 22 by 9 by 14.
Does it have a battery inside?
Yeah, it's got batteries, but they're both under 150 mAh, which is TSA compliant and UN compliant.
My name is Dennis Lorenzo with Cooper Airlines. I'm the senior manager of baggage. Here with Kevin O'Donnell. Totally impressed. I was like, what the hell is this? Impressive.
It is practical because you should have seen me coming into Union Station this morning with my two toes, like lugging them across the street. Like I could have packed everything.
We've gone through proof of concept. We've had over 100 people ride them. The response has been unanimously positive. No matter who you put on the bag, as soon as they get their feet on the pegs and hit that throttle, just a smile. Not only is it functional, but it's an awful lot of fun.
Oh my God, everyone tried it.
What do you think?
I thought that was so cool.
So after a year of really hard work and assembling a great team of people who have backed us all the way, we're finally at the point where we're ready to go to production. With your help, we'll be able to do that and change the way the world travels.
Now, how much would you pay?
Oh, gosh. It's got to be...
Do you have any idea? Because
I don't.
They did Kickstarter. Chat room, any guess to what this sells for?
I would... Oh, gosh. I don't know. Like, my first thought is, like, hundreds. Like, $200 to maybe, like, $600. I don't know.
Oh, well. Oh, 800, 15, 5,
a thousand.
Okay.
Yeah, some people are thinking thousands. I think it's
like
a small go-kart.
They're closer than you.
Really? No.
Okay. When it first started, the first premiums were $995.
Oh, my God.
And I believe now the cheapest one is $1,095.
Oh, my gosh.
And
holy
the list
cow.
Price, they're saying, could be $1,500. Now, the first thing is, it is an amazing thing that they've done, okay, that 85% of the bag is still available for your stuff. The problem I see is if someone runs into someone else two or three times at an airport, I'm afraid they're going to ban them.
Right.
And then you're stuck with an $1,100 suitcase.
Grounded. Yeah, that doesn't have much room. Yeah.
I mean, I guess you could ride it up to the terminal, but if you can't ride it in the terminal – and the bag itself weighs 19 pounds. I don't know. Unlike the cruising cooler, which could be used outdoors, I'm not sure how this is going to work.
Yeah.
They're supposed to start shipping very soon, and it said January 2017. So that's when I guess we'll see what they're like in airports. And someone in the chat room already said, I can imagine me running into someone else's suitcases with this.
Yeah, absolutely. So, like, I can't believe it costs almost $1,000. First off, you're going to look like a fool driving
through. That's what I think. I'm afraid. Nick in the chat room is saying, will it fit? It is. There was a quick shot there, Nick, of the man putting it in the airport sizer bag for taking on board the flight, and it fit fine. So it is compliant with taking on airplanes. The motor and battery meet TSA requirements. I just think...
Here are the downsides. I'm looking at the tech specs right now. First off, you have to be under 180 pounds to ride this thing. That means that I couldn't ride it. I'm above 180 pounds. I couldn't...
Well, you know what? It's
you're right. Range. Oh, that's range. Okay.
Yeah, it's based on 180 pound rider.
Okay,
So it seems like you could be heavier, then your range would be cut down.
Okay. It doesn't. Max rider weight is 260. Okay, that makes me.
Oh, there you go. You're fine.
I'm fine. There we go. It is 19 pounds. Empty. I think. That's what I was seeing in the chat room, is that it was 19 pounds empty. Yeah, bag weight, 19 pounds.
Loke is saying, you could play bumper bags in the airport.
Yeah. I mean, it's interesting, but it's one of those features, it's one of those products that's like, yeah, if I had $1,000,000, I might buy it.
I just worry about running into someone, and also I don't have the nerve to do it. I like attention on a stage.
Right.
I don't want.
I don't want to be silently judged from the people at the airport bar that's like tootling along.
Hey, look at that guy, yeah.
Yeah,
and you'll
exactly.
You'll never get to your gate either because 19 people got to say, hey, stop. Hey,
whoa,
you
slow
get
down.
Oh, yeah. Can I ride it? Wait a minute. My flight's in 10 minutes. Oh, it's just taking me a minute to ride it. Yeah. Anyway, like I said.
It's amazing. You can't deny that it is interesting and fun to look at and daydream about. But practically, I don't see anyone spending $1,000,
$1,100,
to and possibly more, to ride around in an airport.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the technology is really amazing.
It
that
really
they
is.
Built something you can ride that weighs just 19 pounds. But in a crowded airport, I have an idea they're just going to say no motorized bags allowed.
No, I mean, they do allow, you know, motorized wheelchairs, you know, and people
That's
seem
true.
To be pretty okay with that. I mean, that's the other thing is if you're someone who is, you know, mobily impaired, if, you know, you had a broken ankle or something, like, that would be awesome, you know? But, yeah, huh.
Interesting.
Couldn't I just ride the bag to my destination? I mean, do I even need an airplane at that point? You know, just, you know, it's 230 miles that way.
Yeah, get the long-range batteries.
Let's go.
You can drag a wagon full of batteries.
Exactly.
There you go.
Very interesting. You know what I could really see is PR companies using this thing and bringing it to conventions and riding around on one that had their logo on the back.
With big logos
on the
side.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Well, I'll see how they demo it at CES.
Exactly.
Because one of the things that they're going to be showing.
I can't knock it too much because I want one. But at the same time, I just don't feel like it's going to hit wide-ranging appeal. But you know what? They don't need to. I guess a $1,000 bag would have never hit wide-ranging appeal. So very, very interesting and cool. Good find. The Moto Bag.
The Moto Bag.
You can back it now.
Now, our third gadget is more in everybody's price range because it's under $8. So let's take a look at the no-tie shoelaces.
Hey, it's Sticky Bartolo, man's maddest writer in the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. Any idea what that is, you know? I play the What the Heck Is It game. What the heck is it?
It's a handle, okay. Traveling handle.
I'll tell you this.
You need a lot
of these for it to actually work. And I'll show you what it is. Ta-da! Is it clear now? See the difference between
these? I thought these were for kids. Said it wrong.
Kids or adult, they make both sizes.
They go in and out all through the sneaker. This is actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of these things. So this is the way you buy them. So they are no-tie laces, but they look like laces. They come in two different sizes for kids' shoes and adult shoes. They're $8, and this is what it's like when you get a pair. There's a set for each side. You use as many as you need. For example, this sneaker just used 7, and that's why I have this one left over. And you have to make sure you start at the bottom. And let me pull one of them out. Actually, I can turn it sideways. I'll show you. It's a little hard to do.
It's harder to get it out than to put it in, which is why I couldn't get it back out.
You. So this is what you do. You pop it through the hole, squeeze this together, push it into the hole, and when it gets to the other side of the hole, it pops open like that, okay? And it holds it in place. And, you know, I try to test everything out, so it was a little bizarre. And by the way, no one noticed. I wore them all day at MAD. I wore regular laces, and I wore these.
No one stopped and went, Dick, what's wrong with your shoes?
And I like the fact that it basically turns any pair of shoes into a slip-on. They come in many different colors. They're $7.99 and Amazon Prime. $7.99 for one pair. And I think all of these are all different colors.
Whoa.
So you can get to match a sneaker you have, or if you want to make a sneaker you have look extra bright, you can buy yellow and red. That is it. Very easy to install. Well, semi-easy to install. Once you get the hang of it, it's easy to do. Dick DeBartolo, they call it the goodbye tie. A lot of people, they call it all different things. I bought the Homa no-tie shoelaces, but the Homa no-tie shoelaces came out to be this. So I assume one manufacturer is making them and every company is just putting their own name on it. Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv, tying up another little video. Bye.
Huh. I would worry that the sizes weren't correct. You know, I have some shoes that the width is really small and some that are wide apart. I'd be worried.
Oh, that's interesting. I've put them on two different pairs of shoes so far and
maybe there's a standard that I'm not
trouble.
Yeah. It's interesting.
But I don't know.
Yeah, there's all sorts of different colors just running through these. You know, we got light blue, brown, black, gray, neon, green, rainbow, all sorts. White, red, purple. I mean, yeah, just every single color imaginable.
If you travel a lot, these are also great when you go through security.
Right.
Because any shoes you have, unless they're loafers, you just slip off like they are loafers.
I also wonder, would they stay cleaner than normal shoelaces?
You know what? It says that since they're silicone, that you can wash them if they get dirty. Just run a sponge over them and clean them because they're waterproof.
Yeah, very little sticks to silicone. Mostly it's only silicone sticks to silicone. Very interesting. I am intrigued. I may be wanting to buy a pair because it would be nice to not have to tie your shoes every day. For some reason, my shoes always come untied, and I'm always having that issue. And right now, I'm looking at my shoelaces. They're mostly gray.
They're elasticy. The chat room is asking, are they elastic? Yeah, they're stretchy. That's why you can slip them on like they are a loafer.
Interesting. I think that they're quite nice. For $8. It's a nice little experiment to try, see if they work out for you. Get whatever color you want, or it looks like they even have some packs that are multicolor.
Multicolor, yes.
And very interesting. Now I just got to decide what color to get. Probably red. There you go.
There you go. Oh, to match your hair. Perfect.
Exactly.
You'll be top and bottom. You'll be red.
Right, exactly. You can even do crazy designs.
If you roll down a flight of stairs, you'll still look red no matter which end is
exactly.
up. It's perfect.
Exactly. Yep.
Perfect.
People might start talking to my shoes, go, I didn't know you could do a handstand. yeah, absolutely. Okay, the Homer no tie shoelaces for kids and adults over at Amazon just for $8, $7.99.
$7.99 on Amazon Prime.
With that.
Well, that brings us to our final Chad's Crappy Corner.
Crappy Corner.
Get it.
So this is the end of Stocking Stuffer Month. And I always like to be frugal in my Crappy Corner because it is crappy. If you spend over too much money, there's basically no way to get it not crappy. I happen to be in Dollar General, and I saw this gadget, and I thought it was absolutely perfect.
Well, you are lucky
perfect.
To have all these stores,
I know.
Five and Under, and
they're just right nearby.
General, and then you have that big 50-cent palace that's opening up near you.
Yeah, it's great. I'm loving it. So this is Dollar General. Everything in that store is a dollar, and this is a little science experiment that is perfect for a stocking stuffer. And there's actually four of these experiments. There's one that you can do to make crystals. There's one where you can make like gel balls.
Well, wait, you did a crystal one.
I did the Star Wars crystal one before.
And like 3 weeks later, it started
exactly. I didn't
growing out of the bottle and all over the shelves.
It was too. I had heated it up too much, so none of the crystals started forming. But I finally got it to form eventually. And then finally, I forget what the last one is. I'm trying to look at the photo here, but I cannot tell. It's not large enough to determine what the text of this is. Either way, the one that I found and the one that I picked out was making instant snow. I thought that would be perfect for the season that we're currently in. So this is how we make instant snow. And it says that it is instant. So hopefully we'll be able to do it here on the show. Let's go ahead and open it up and show it off. The product first has a lot of warnings right at the bottom. Warning, this set contains chemicals. So we got the instant snow on the back. It kind of tells you the directions. And kind of with a tab, pull it open. There's the instant snow pack with another another warning. You get a little spoon and some instructions, and that's all that's in there.
Aren't you supposed to keep that in the freezer?
It's instant snow. It's instant snow.
Oh, okay.
Right, we don't need to put that in the freezer.
Oh, okay.
So it looks like put a spoonful of the magic snow crystals into a cup. Just a spoonful. It's a spoonful of magic crystals. And where? Oh, it doesn't look like there's a perforated edge. We can hopefully pull this open. I'm getting instant crystal. Oh, there's a hole in my instant crystals.
Oh, no.
Maybe we can. Oh, yep. We can use this to our advantage to get in here, though. Okay, so we have some materials. We have our science materials here. I have an empty cup, an empty glass that it's asking for. So go ahead and grab a spoonful of it. This looks like a nice, healthy spoonful there. Oh, and I'm dropping it all over our set. And let's dump it in there. And then it says to add 2 ounces of water to watch it expand. And that's it, really. So I have 2 ounces of water right here in this other glass. And let's see what happens. I'm kind of worried, actually. Mm. Woo! Oh, whoa! There it goes.
Is it making snow? Did it make snow? Oh, wait a minute. It's hardened already.
It's gel. Oh, it's kind of crystallizing into
snow. Wow.
Oh, look at that. The side of the glass, it's removing
itself. It's snowbound.
Itself. Yeah, it's removing itself from the side of the glass. It turned into a gel there briefly. And it said, have fun. That was the last step.
Someone said you made slush.
Yeah. Yeah, this feels a less like snow and more like gel. Okay, here, 1 second. Then we'll go to the wide shot. And here, I'll pull out the spoon.
Does it come with a shovel to shovel it?
Does it come with a weather advisory warning? Yeah, after stirring it up, kind of looks like snow. It looks adorable and fun. Okay, here, let's go back to the product, and I can kind of show it all. After kind of just mixing it up a bit, you have a little bit of goop. It's not too wet. It's pretty dry.
It's pretty dry. Okay.
Do you feel like if you were to see this in my hand? Look, I just walked outside.
If you said you came in and that was snow, I would believe you.
I picked up the snow outside.
Also, if you said it was sherbet, I would believe you.
I wonder if you said it was sherbet. Yeah, it kind of looks... I was surprised that I just didn't put the whole packet in, but it only said put a spoonful of magic snow crystals into a cup. I don't have any more water with me, so I can't really try the experiment again, unfortunately. There you go. So you got some snow.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't know if I'm, like, super impressed with this or not. I was expecting it to be, like,
flaky.
This really does kind of pack together a lot. Here's the photo that they used. I don't know if it's going to focus or not. I don't know if that's what it's created or not. Won't freeze your hands. Great learning tool. Put a spoonful of magic snow in the cup. That's it. Magic snow crystals.
Is it available online, do you know?
So you can find it online on the Dollar Tree website.
Oh.
For just $1. You have to buy it in cases. So... Yeah, so it'll be $24 for 24 different learning experiments, and I believe that each case comes with all 4, so you can't just buy one, you have to buy all 4 in the case. So if you don't happen to have a Dollar Tree near you, you can buy a case of this snow. It's letting me click that.
Okay.
So there you go. I could go grab some more water and try this again. It was a little messy, and I now have snow bits.
Yeah, maybe you should.
All over the the studio.
Well, you know what? I saw there was a rating there. What did people say?
This is 4.3 stars on their website.
How many people?
Out of eight people.
Eight people.
Eight people have reviewed this product. And there's a lot of instant snow out there. I didn't see any other instant snow that was for under a dollar, though. So, it's around 1,000. I like, interesting. Grow your own gel balls. Perfect for kids K to third grade. Amazing quality product. Great stuff. Shipping was overpriced badly. There's all sorts. I mean, the gel balls I know are a very
I have their popular album, the gel balls.
Yeah, exactly. I know. Everyone loves
group.
Those.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, those are very popular right now. There's a lot of people on YouTube making videos where they fill swimming pools with them, and they just do all sorts of weird stuff with gel balls, and they're fun because they come in a small little bitty packet, and then they suck up the water that's around them. And then you have these, gel balls that you can throw at people, and they explode kind of like water balls, water balloons.
And if you happen to like this, Eric Duckman in the chat room found 10 gallons of it.
Oh my gosh, of Insta Snow?
For $25.
Oh my gosh, okay.
That equals like 1,000 packs of what you bought.
Oh my gosh, yeah, this is, it doesn't say the ounces that's in this. I guess I'll pour it back into this cup here. It doesn't say exactly how much this is. What is this? This is acid polyacrylic. Aceti? I don't know exactly how you say. Oh, this is. That was the Spanish side. it's polyacrylic acid, sodium salt, and water.
It says, do not get on your hands. Do
exactly.
not add water.
Exactly. Yeah, and of course you'd want to be careful with your kids around this. Of course, you don't want them to eat it or get it in their eyes or anything like that. So there you go. Make your own snow for under a dollar. If you have a Dollar Tree near you, there's a whole bunch of different science experiments over there at Dollar Tree. Or you could buy a case of them online and entertain a whole family, maybe even a whole classroom. Just this science experiment. I thought it was very fun. Okay, with that, that's really it. That's it for this month's Crappy Corner. I'm going to give you guys one more chance before the next episode to send in your best and worst gadgets of 2016. That's what we're going to be doing next episode. That they saw on this show. Right. We're going to be doing an episode all about those gadgets next episode, so there won't be a Crappy Corner. After that, we'll be back in 2017 with a brand new month, and we'll be creating a straw poll for our patrons over at patreon.com/gizwiz for you guys to choose 2017's Crappy Corner. So thank you guys so much. With that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
Well, no one sent in any videos for this week's show, so I went to Dick's real gadget warehouse and found a product from Sony you probably don't know about. See for yourself.
Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv with another gadget from Dick's Gadget Warehouse. We spend so much money on special sound effects. All right, so I have something neat from Sony. All right, so Sony made some astoundingly popular gadgets, the Walkman for one. It wouldn't surprise me if it sold in the billions. There were so many different models of it. But here's something you may not have known that Sony even made. This was for people who like sporting events. It was a way to go to a sporting event, have an AM/FM radio,
and an 8 magnification monocular device. Okay, this folded back, so if you wore glasses, you could put your eye right up to it. And then if you didn't wear glasses, this became a little sunshade. And the official name of this was, let's go over to the video screen, the Sony SRF-X90 Ultimate Sports AM-FM Radio with 8x monocular for watching sport. You can only watch one sport at a time, obviously.
It's my favorite sport.
$100
Whoa!
Wow, that gadget warehouse is going to pay off for me because I've been storing this. This is now going on 25 years old, and I've been storing it at only $400 a month. Okay? That's for sure. I mean, that's for real. There is a gadget warehouse, and I do pay $400 a month. So it came with these matching headsets. And they tell you in the instruction book to adjust the cable here because this is also the FM antenna. Okay, so that plugged in so that you could actually watch the sport event, tune it in on the radio. And 8x magnification is pretty good. I tried it out on the street. The problem is at 8x and no sort of image stabilization, there is kind of a little... You know, it depends on how steady your hands are. But that was water resistant. Any other features? Oh, in the back, there were a couple things. There was a way to go to the band, AM, FM. And there was even a volume limiter. So that there were two, there were three. There was full on volume, to what you set it. And you could limit it with option one or option two. And I think that that is it. The tuning knob and the volume control. It only used one AA battery. That's it. The Sony Ultimate Sports AM-FM radio with 8x monocular for sport watching. And it looks like nobody reviewed it. But you know what? It's 25 years old and it was such a big seller that there are only 5 left in stock. Okay, and outside of taking it in the box to show it to you, this one is also brand new. Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Rider, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at Dick's Gadget Warehouse. Bye!
I like how the bottom of that box just said sports in big letters. Sports! You like sports? This is made for sports!
Yes, yes.
Very interesting warehouse. I think that the best Giz Wiz gadgets do this is they take two very vastly different gadgets and combine them into one. You have your AM-FM radio. That's great. How about a monocular? Put them together. Yeah. What do you got? Something from Sony. There you go.
I think an AM-FM binoculars would have been better, right?
Right.
Because binoculars just kind of weird. But there it is. They made it, and obviously someone still has some.
Yeah, look at those. it's just so funny. And also, like, who is touting around, you know, making sure that you can listen to FM while at the game? Everyone just uses their phones now to check in on their favorite
thing. Exactly.
It's quite amazing. It looks nice. I like the style of it. It looks...
It was well done.
It really was.
They at least got rid of the one I have. Maybe they only made 6. Maybe those other 5 are the only other...
Exactly.
The ones they have.
Exactly. And look, someone's bought 2 of them. There's now only 3 left.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Oh my God, they're going like hotcakes.
Yeah, they're going like crazy. So you got to get them in now. Okay. So the Sony, I love their Sony does this with everything. Their naming convention. SRFX90. Woo! What a nice name. Monocular. Sport FM AM. Very, very, very cool. With that, let's move on to the letter!
Here come the letters. The lovely letters. Here come the Giz Wiz
letter of the week is from Tyler, who writes, "Hi, Dick and Chad. I've been watching the show every week for years and really enjoy it. On this week's episode, you talked about how great it would be to have permanent LED holiday lights.
Oh, you're telling me it's real? Oh, I'm excited.
On the outside of your house or business, the product exists. I have a friend involved in selling and installing these systems here in Arizona, and they are quickly expanding to other states. Have a look at trimlight.net. And it's signed, keep up the good work, Tyler. So,
yeah, this is it. This is what I want. You got a house. You got some trim lights.
And the frustrations of hanging holiday lights every
You got year. A cartoon explaining it?
Tangled cords. Broken clips. And cumbersome ladders. Let us introduce you to the...
Chad fell.
I know. That would be me. Just make that guy's hair red.
That matches the color of your home. The channel protects and hides all of the wires from view and locks our high-quality LED lights in place, giving you bright, beautiful lights at night that are hardly noticeable during the day. Our LEDs use 1/10 of the power than that of an incandescent bulb and can last 10 times as long, so you can be sure you will enjoy your lights for years to come. There are hundreds of color combinations and programs to celebrate any holiday, sporting event, or any other occasion all year round. Are you ready to have the most innovative new product for your home or business? Call Trim Light today.
Very interesting. Trim
now,
light.
You know, do they have? They have a store because they are expensive.
Become Let's a see. Dealer. Here we go. Contact locations. How to install. Calculator. Here we go. Let's say step one, what time of trim do you have? I don't know, but A, maybe, possibly. Metal soffits, exposed wooden free support, I have no clue. Step two, are you interested in a double strand system? No, don't need that.
No.
Specifically, what spacing between the bulbs? Oh, you know, normal. 6 inches?
12 inches?
Well, let's get it.
Six is going to look too much like an arcade, I think.
Okay. How many feet do you need? Plan on 10% waist.
Wow, how wide is your house?
I have no clue. Let's just say a football field's worth 300. How about
300?
That?
300. Oh my god.
Yeah, why not? No, I mean cuz you got multiple layers.
Oh, that's true. Okay.
And it's also pitched. I literally have no clue. How many jumps do you have including from the I don't know. Two jumps, two layers of house? How much jumper would you need? I have no clue. This is why we need someone to come out here. 20 jumpers.
Yeah. 20. Okay.
Do you need cable channel jumpers? Yeah, sure. Another 20 feet of that. Do you need roof cable covers? Yeah, two of those. Do you have a cover, the back cover? How many feet? 6 feet. Okay, so does it tell me a price? Bill of materials.
It doesn't give a price.
Doesn't tell me a price. I went through all that.
I saw a kit that was like $1,500, but I don't know what it included.
There is a cart here. They put it under more.
Is that dumb?
That's pretty stupid. I agree. Trim light systems. Here we go.
There you go.
Full house kits.
DIY kits.
There you go. Okay. So here's a normal. Okay. Look at this. I was pretty far off. $199. So 200 feet system. $1,300. A 153-foot system. $1,000. Wow, these are expensive.
They are.
Man. Okay. I mean, Yeah, I guess you're doing it for the whole house the whole time.
And you're doing it in a metal channel.
Yeah.
And they have all the sandstone connected so you can go around corners and stuff. It's still expensive, but it would be a one-time.
It would be a one-time fee. I still don't know if I would ever spend $1,000 on installing lines. I mean, at that price, it's like, how much does it cost to get an installer out here? Probably $100, $200. So it would take 5 years. You know, if I wanted the convenience of never hanging a light and having it look great every season, it'd cost about $200, I bet, per season. I don't know.
You're going to have to get one of those things that you just stick in the ground, but it only does red and red and green.
Exactly. Okay, here's the deal. You know what, Trim Lights? I'll test out your product. Come on over to my house and install it, and I'll tell people all around the world how great it is.
There you go.
You know,
there you
just,
go. Tyler, tell your friend.
I won't charge you guys a consulting fee or anything.
Tell your friend in Arizona to come.
Exactly.
To Texas.
That's cool. That's amazing that it exists. I'm so happy that it exists. But it is, and to be honest, if I remember looking at the bill of sale for my house, and they put in stuff that you know that's like, oh, this porch overhang cost $1,000 to make, and it's like, wow, well, that doesn't seem, you know, if that was built into the house from the very beginning, and they just said you have lights under your overhang, you didn't have to do anything. It's, you know, now you've just added a little bit to the cost of the house. I could see that happening from a new construction standpoint.
No, it's the same when you buy a boat.
Right.
Because you're spending so much money for the boat, it goes, microwave oven, just $1,000 extra.
Exactly. Would you like a pillow? Would you like an all-terrain pillow? $300. Exactly.
Yeah. Bilge pump, $300. The bilge pump is $99. Yeah.
Exactly. So. Exactly. So anyway, that's really awesome. I'm glad that it exists. I'm glad that it is out there. I'm seeing the app kind of on their website, and it makes me want to see it even more because it looks a little basic, but who knows? And hopefully each LED is
addressable.
Addressable, exactly. So yeah, there's a lot of things that I am interested about this. I'll probably do a little bit of research on my own to find out some more. This is a 3-minute video about trim lights. Are they bright? That's a good question. I mean, that looks good.
Oh, this does look nice.
It is a little to make sure that it's hidden. It does point down, which makes sense. But that does kind of...
Oh, you know what? Now, that's weird. It says two colors or one color. That's not a lot of option.
No, that's what I was worried about. Is, you know, we saw that one light strip from the letter, and I apologize because I forget the name of the person who sent it in.
Oh, yeah, last week.
Last week, you know, we had that meteor option, and each LED was addressable, and it was
every
super
six
cool.
Inches was addressable.
Exactly. Yeah. So, you know, I would want something that was that powerful if it was going to cost me thousands of dollars and be permanently installed on my house, you know?
I'm quickly trying to find that guy's name. It was Buddy Yates.
Buddy Yates. Buddy, that's right, Buddy. Yep. Yeah, I mean, that's what I would want, is something that was that powerful so I knew it was future-proof. And this, I still feel like they could add just a few more things. Because how neat would it be if they had maybe a snow effect where each, you know, blinked and faded off in a random, you know, sort of way, or if you had a chase that went around the whole house and that sort of thing. You know, that is, I mean, once again, you're just cha-ching, cha-ching. Yes, yes, customer.
We can do that.
We can make that happen. Cha-ching, cha-ching.
Do you want it to say podcasting live right this minute?
Exactly,
we can do that.
Exactly, right? So anyway, very interesting. I'm glad it exists. Very cool product. And thanks for sending that over, Tyler. Thank you so much. And that wraps it up for the last normal episode of 2016. We'll be coming at you next week with our best of, worst of. Make sure you get in your suggestions for the best and worst gadgets that we've covered this year and email them. Just a simple list, just a simple name of the gadget, or if you happen to remember the episode that it's in, go ahead with that, but we're not looking for anything fancy. Send it over to mail@gizwiz.tv. That's also the place where you can send over your videos, your gadget warehouse videos. We need those as well, although we won't be showing those off next week.
No, we won't have one next week, but we need one for the week of January 7th. I think that's on next show.
Are you going to CES?
I'm going to CES.
Okay, cool. So we'll see so much.
Right. So next week is a regular show on Thursday.
Right.
The following week, we're doing another show on Tuesday because Wednesday morning, I leave at 5 a.m. for the plane to Vegas.
Vegas. I really want to go. CES is so fun, but I don't. I just feel like I don't have a good reason to spend money on a hotel and get out there. But cool. Have some fun at CES. With that, we've come to the conclusion of our show, but don't wait! Don't hesitate to back us on Patreon, patreon.com/gizwiz. Patreon is the place to support independent content creators like ourselves. And we have a Patreon page, patreon.com/gizwiz, as I mentioned before, where you can back us, and we really heartily thank all of the support that we get on Patreon. You guys are amazing. You guys make the show happen every single week. You guys really, really rock it every week with your support. Thank you so much.
Thank you for 86 shows. This
86?
Is our 86 independent production.
86 shows. You guys are absolutely amazing. And thank you so much. Patreon is a recurring payment, so every episode we put out, put in a little. So if you get anything out of this crazy show that we put on, thank you so much for giving back just a little bit. If you don't want to do a recurring situation, we do have a link on our website right underneath the Patreon banner. You just click on Patreon at the top. Scroll right underneath and there's a PayPal link to just do a one-time donation. Thank you so much to those of you who support the show that way as well. Hey, we are not over with the fun stuff. Go to gizwiz.biz and play What the Heck Is It? And next week, it'll probably be 2 weeks from now.
It'll be
2017.
30, it ends New Year's Eve night.
New Year's Eve night, so play What the Heck Is It?
So
here
New
is
Year's
the gadget.
Day. We'll pick the winners of the day after.
So this is a trash can lid prettier. Makes trash can lids look prettier. Clips onto the bottom of, or the top of your trash can, and serves as a way to keep the smells out, but the trash in.
That's a nice great slogan. Let's market that.
Keep the smells
keeps
out,
the
but the trash
smells
in.
Out in. I like it.
If you have a correct answer, there's 12 Mad Magazines signed by Dickie D. But if you have a fun, hilarious, clever, or unique answer, there's 24 Mad Magazines signed by Dickie D himself. This is a Mad Magazine. The 20 dumbest people, events, and things of 2016. And that's a classic magazine, so that'd be great to get from Dickie D. And get a guess over at gizwiz.biz. If you want to watch the show live, you can do so at gizwiz.tv. That's our website. And if you don't happen to catch it live and join the chat room, you can always subscribe to the show or check out all of our previous episodes over at gizwiz.tv in the episodes tab at the top. Or scroll down just a little bit and you can see our most recent shows. With that, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next week with the best of, worst of. Don't forget to email your suggestions and we will see you then.
I'll be here.